And Hamish, I wonder, what does the data show in terms of the areas that, you think, you know, need attention? Obviously, those HVAC systems, we know with, this being an airborne virus, how important those are to making school a safe place.
Yeah, I mean, as Ashley said, the HVAC systems are a concern. I think when we're looking at the academic and engagement pieces of it, those are also of large concern. That's I think the area of special attention that we see. First, you know, student engagement has been a major concern over the last year. Connecticut tracked attendance and did see a substantial dip, especially in some of our larger cities, of students engaging in schoolwork and attending school each day. And on top of that, you know, districts are tracking the failure and pass rate of their high school students, and they're seeing that a lot of more kids are struggling to pass their core classes, which means that that does not put them on track to graduate on time, which has a whole slew of potential issues down the road. On-time graduation typically is a really strong indicator of future success. So we know that those, we know somewhat what the issues are in terms of, you know, re-engaging kids and making sure they're showing up to school and participating and completing schoolwork. But we also know that we have some work to do when it comes to how to do that in a way that invites families into the conversation. Mm-hmm. And I think that it's important to note too that this wasn't only a concern from the pandemic. We knew that there were engagement and academic concerns prior to that. So this is really like the swelling of that over the course of a year and a half, where we are wonderfully situated to fix these problems, but we should do so in the utmost urgency.
And Ashley, is that the same kind of thing you're saying? Oh yeah, go.
I was just gonna add one more point because I know we have parents listening. I think it's important to note that with the federal funds, and juggling these decisions at the district level, they need to engage families and their community in their decisions. So there's an opportunity for parents to directly get in there and say, you know, this is what worked for my child. This is what I hope will continue. I hope this money is, you know, being allocated and earmarked for that purpose. So there, I just wanted to make sure that they knew, because often most parents don't know that's available to them.
Right, and I wonder about the social, emotional, mental health needs of the students, because oftentimes school is also that safe place, and they can, you know, be with their peers.
You're exactly right. I know, you know, my own children definitely experienced a little bit of an impact there. My JerseyCan got to speak with a few districts, and one of them was Collingswood, New Jersey, and they ended up last summer, because they've seen this for years. To Hamish's point, some of these challenges are not new. They had been planning to implement an SEL curriculum embedded in their school day across all subject areas with their staff, their special staff, all of it, so that it could be very responsive. And so they did that in the midst of the pandemic. They hired a clinical team to support. And what those clinicians also did, as they were getting hours for, you know, their degrees moving on for school counseling and school psychology, is they pulled students out, had conversations targeted around the zones of regulation. So they had developed this curriculum, embedded it in the day, and then saw growth for their students, both socially, emotionally, and academic. Because you can't access academic, you know, strength and growth until your needs are met. And so they saw a lot of success with that this year.